So, yeah, usage limits. It's just reality now if you're building with AI tools. Since August 28th, Claude's Max plan flipped everything, and honestly, Anthropic only got around to updating the dev docs a couple weeks ago. You know what I mean? If you're bouncing between Codex, Cursor, Claude Code, whatever, these limits aren't just some random number. They're the difference between shipping your project, getting blocked, or running out of steam right when you're in the flow. And yeah, even Codex has its own session rules now, but I'll save that breakdown for another video. So, what actually changed? How do sessions really work now? And okay, how do you actually avoid hitting that limit reached wall in the middle of a build? Stick around. I'm breaking it all down. And just real quick, I'm Daniel. I've been in the Apple trenches for 8 years now, started out freelancing, helping clients ship their ideas, learning the hard way what actually works and what just burns you out. But after Dub25, I went all in on solo dev. Since then, I've shipped a bunch of my own apps, started building everything out in public, and lately, Crafters Lab is where I've been putting all my energy. It isn't just another tutorial site or Discord to scroll past. This is my real home base for solo devs who treat AI like a teammate, not just a vending machine. Every deep dive guide, app blueprint, design workflow, even the exact Notion team spaces I use daily, they're all live here. SwiftBrain, the full agents ops, and even my own playbook with real MD files. It's all finally in one place on a private indie first platform. If you want real systems, real code, and a real community for solo devs, not just another AI clone farm, that's what I'm building. And yeah, if you're part of the Patreon crew, huge thanks. And heads up, everything's moving over to crafterslab.dev. All right, let's just get super real for a second. Usage limits used to feel kind of chill, right? Like if you're coming from something like ChatGPT Cursor or even Midjourney, you probably got used to seeing a message counter or a daily limit, and you just kind of paced yourself around that. Maybe you ran out every now and then, but it was all pretty predictable. With Claude's latest update, though, yeah, it's a whole new game. And the way sessions work now, especially with Claude Code, trips up pretty much everyone at first. So here's the core. Sessions aren't just about messages anymore. They're blocks of time, 5 hours to be exact. As soon as you send your first message, whether it's in the browser chat or firing up Claude Code in your terminal, that 5 hour clock starts ticking. You could blast through 45 prompts in one sprint or just send a polite thanks and come back after lunch. Doesn't matter. 5 hours after you started, your next message burns a brand new session. And the real gotcha? These limits are shared across everything. So whether you're pairing with Claude in chat or deep in the CLI doing real indie coding with Claude Code, it all counts against the same usage pool. There's no magic stash of extra sessions just for the terminal, and there's no separate allowance if you like to split your time between coding and chatting. If you're running heavy prompts, working on a bigger repo, or doing something with a bunch of parallel Claude Code jobs, you'll hit your ceiling even faster, especially if you've got stuff like auto accept turned on. The more intense your workflow, the quicker the meter runs down. For most solo devs, the big plan differences are: Pro gets you unlimited sessions, but each session is capped at 45 messages or 10 to 40 Claude Code prompts per 5 hour block, depending on how heavy your repo or workflow is. Max gives you 50 sessions a month, but each session lets you do a way bigger push: 225 messages or 50 to 200 prompts. If you're on Max Plus, still 50 sessions, but now you get up to 900 messages or 200 to 800 prompts per window, which is wild. But honestly, if you're running parallel jobs or hammering a huge code base, even that can vanish sooner than you think. And here's where it really lands for indie devs. If you're used to dipping in and out, maybe a couple quick bug fixes in the morning, a code review after lunch, then some refactor questions after dinner. Each of those could burn a new session if you let more than 5 hours slip in between. Three small check-ins, three sessions. You do that for a week, you start feeling the walls close in. It adds up fast. At first, I honestly hated this, no joke. I'd blow through my whole session stack for the week just because I was scattered, not because I was doing heavy lifting. But once you figure out how the system wants you to work, it actually pushes you into better habits. Batch your work, treat each session like a mini deep dive sprint, and get intentional. There's something satisfying about using every drop of a session, seeing how much you can get done before the window closes. So yeah, the new session model isn't just about throttling, it's about nudging you into a flow where you work smarter, not just more often. And honestly, once you lean into it, it's not all bad. But you've got to know how it actually works, or you're going to hit those limits way sooner than you think. Here's where the numbers really start to matter, right? I mean, you can vibe all day on the idea of sessions and message windows, but until you look at what you're actually getting for your money, you won't really feel the limits until you hit that wall. With this new Claude pricing, honestly, you got to pay attention. On Pro, it's $20 a month, and yeah, you can open as many sessions as you want. Unlimited sounds sweet, but here's the catch. You only get about 45 messages in a 5-hour window, or maybe 10 to 40 prompts if you're using Claude Code and your project's not a monster. Once you hit that, you're done until you kick off a new session. So if you're just poking at small bugs or asking a few one-off questions, it'll probably feel fine. But anything more, you're gonna hit that cap a lot faster than you expect. Now the max plan, $100. This is for anyone who wants to do real long haul work, like those big all day sprints or feature builds. Here you're limited to 50 sessions a month, but each one gives you about 225 messages or 50 to 200 prompts, which feels massive compared to Pro. But it's a trap if you're not careful. You might only send a handful of messages in a session, but each one still counts. Doesn't matter if you use 2 or 200. That's one session gone. And yeah, if you burn through those 50 before the month's out, you're locked out until things reset. You really start to notice how precious every session is. And then max plus, which is kind of wild, $200, still 50 sessions, but each session is just a monster. You get up to 900 messages, or honestly, enough room to do a serious dev marathon. You'd think, there's no way I'll burn through 50 of these. But honestly, if you work in lots of little bursts or just check in too often, you'll be out before you know it. It doesn't matter how light you go in each one of every new 5-hour block you start. It's another session ticked off the list. And here's what trips up almost everyone. It's not the message count that'll get you. You look at those huge message windows and think you'll never hit the wall, but the real killer is just using up sessions too casually. Every time you hop in for a quick review or you open a session before breakfast, then get distracted and check back after lunch, yeah, that's another session gone. You can honestly wipe out your whole monthly allowance in a week if you're not careful. And trust me, that's a way harder wall than running out of tokens. You just hit this total stop and there's nothing you can do except wait for your limit to reset. So honestly, here's what I've learned. Treat every session like it's a little deep work sprint. Make a list, prep your questions, batch everything you can. If you're mostly doing quick focused work, Pro is totally fine. But if you live in Claude, planning, building, refactoring, and running code with Claude Code, Max or Max Plus are only worth it if you make those sessions really count. Otherwise, yeah, it's way too easy to run out before you even get to the fun part of building. Okay, so let's be honest, running into session burnout as a solo dev just hits different. You ever have one of those weeks where you're in the zone, hopping in and out of Claude, and then bam, you hit the wall? No more sessions, nothing left to reset, and suddenly you're stuck looking at that wait until your usage limits reset, warning like it's the world's slowest loading bar. No joke, I've been there more times than I'd like to admit. So yeah, this is the pain point that nobody really warns you about. The first time it happens, it feels like a glitch or a bug, but nope, it's just the system doing what it's supposed to do. You hit your cap, you're done for the week or month, and there's nothing you can do except wait or upgrade your plan. I don't know. It almost feels like the universe is forcing you to take a break, right? But the thing is, you don't want to be that dev who just gets stranded mid-feature with nothing left to ship. Here's where the real indie workflow hacks start to matter. For me, batching is everything. I keep a running list in Notion of every bug, every refactor, every little doc update or question I know I'll want to ask. So when it's session time, I just go down the list. No fluff, no thanks. Messages, no random pinging, just to see if Claude's still there. Every prompt has to count because every message eats into your window. And honestly, planning my work around sessions, not just messages, change the game for me. Like, if I know I'm about to step away from my desk or get pulled into something else, I just don't start a new session. I wait. I only kick things off when I can actually focus, get in, and get stuff done. If I have to pause, I'll leave the tab open and just not send anything until I'm back. You ever have those days where you check in, get distracted, then come back hours later? That's how you accidentally nuke two or three sessions in a single day for no reason. Brutal. But for what it's worth, there's a weird upside here. These limits actually force you to show up sharper. When you know you only have a set number of sessions, maybe 50 for the month, or even just whatever you've got left for the week, you start prepping more, you hustle harder, and you don't scatter your brain across a million half-done threads. It's wild, but I actually finish more and better when I treat every session like a mini deep work sprint. And hey, if you do hit burnout and run out for the week, don't panic. This is the moment you lean on your backup workflows. Maybe switch to Cursor, Codex, or even just hop over to GPT for a quick second opinion. Or honestly, go old school for a day, write some code, sketch a design, catch up on docs. You'll come back fresher, and half the time, you end up solving something that AI couldn't crack anyway. So yeah, these session limits aren't just some arbitrary wall. They're a real thing you gotta plan for. But if you adapt, batch, and show up with purpose, you'll be surprised how much you can still ship before the timer runs out. So yeah, that's the reality of Claude's session limits now. Not always fun, but honestly, sometimes those constraints force us to build smarter, not just faster. The real trick is using every block with intention, batching your questions, and not letting the limits throw you off your rhythm. And if you ever hit the wall, it's not game over. It's just a pause. Maybe a chance to try something different, recharge, or catch up on the parts of indie dev we all tend to skip. If any of this helped, or if you've got your own session horror stories or clever workarounds, drop them in the comments. I love swapping notes with other solo builders, and you'd be surprised what you can pick up from the community. And hey, if you want to go deeper, get real workflows, blueprints, and all my indie dev resources in one spot, check out crafterslab.dev. That's where I'm building out everything I wish I'd had sooner, from ready-to-go Notion setups, to my real-world Claude and Cursor docs, to a place where solo devs can actually share what's working, not just the highlight reel. If you're feeling this, hit subscribe, share it with someone who needs it, and keep showing up. Sometimes a session timer's just what you need to remind yourself, yeah, you're still in the game, you're still building, and honestly, you're not as alone as you think. Keep crafting, keep learning, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.